Hey, what's up guys? I'm Theo Joe, and bear with me with the audio on this one. I haven't had a chance to put up the acoustic foam in this place yet, so hopefully it doesn't sound too bad. Anyway, on to this video. Now, in the past, I've made some joke videos about getting free cable with one ridiculous method or the other. And while the truth is you can't get cable for free, legally at least, you may not have realized that you can get most network TV channels for free, even in high definition, at least here in the United States. And if you're like me, you might just be assuming that really the only way to get TV service is to go through the cable company, even for the most basic channels. I mean, sure, there are TV antennas, but no one actually uses those anymore, right? Surely those are just for crappy local channels with bad reception and even worse picture quality. But that's where you're wrong. You see, all major network TV channels like NBC, CBS, ABC, PBS, and Fox are actually broadcasted over the air in high quality, high definition video for anyone to grab. And these can be picked up with any TV antenna that costs maybe 30 bucks. And they don't look like what you're probably thinking, which is like a big metal antenna on the roof that takes up half the roof. No, these antennas are pretty small. I mean, this is one I just bought on Amazon, and as you can see, it's basically just a flat sheet that you can stick on the wall or window or anywhere really with good reception. And I'll put a link to this one in the description if you want to get one similar. But the best part about these over-the-air channels is you will never have to pay to watch them. You buy an antenna once and it's good forever. I know this might seem very obvious to many of you who already know about it, but when I was growing up, we always just had cable as long as I can remember. So I just kind of went on thinking that that's how you got TV. You had to go to the cable company. And recently I actually decided that I don't even really watch TV anymore. So I ended up canceling my cable subscription. And the only thing that stopped me from doing it before was the thought that I might rarely want to see what's on the major channels that I mentioned before. And I should therefore at least have the most basic cable package, right? Well, imagine my shock when I found out that I could get all those same channels for free and the radio signals were already flying by me as we speak. So I picked up the antenna and it was an easy choice. For those of you who aren't really familiar with all the antenna stuff, you might be wondering how exactly you do it and how many channels you'll get. Well, the setup is actually really easy. You'll first want to know how many TV broadcast towers are near you so you know how big of an antenna to get. For example, mine is 50 miles. And there are a ton of websites that will actually tell you which channels you should expect to receive based on where you live and how far antenna towers are. So you can look that up if you look up a TV tower reception map or something like that, should come up. Once you buy the antenna, you just plug the coaxial cable into your TV and stick the antenna either on the wall or the window. And mine gets similar reception even when hidden away on the wall, so I put it there instead of the window. And this particular antenna also has an amplifier that's USB powered, so I can just plug that into one of the TV's USB ports and then it amplifies any weak signals. Then once it's all hooked up, your TV should have some function to scan for channels, and that's it. No waiting on hold for the cable company or waiting for a 4-hour window for them to activate your service or renting a cable box. It's just plug and play. In my case, I receive a whopping 90 channels, give or take. Now, I need to point out that there are really only a few of these channels that you'll ever want to watch. I mean, you'll have the main network channels and some local news channels, which are usually affiliated with the major networks too, that are like news. And again, yes, you might even be able to get some HD signals depending on the broadcast station nearby. Most of the big networks do have HD, but the rest of these channels are probably just really crappy public access or Spanish channels that literally you're never gonna watch ever. And here's another interesting fact that the cable companies definitely don't want you to know, for real. It turns out that the high definition video signals you get with an antenna for free are actually better video quality than the cable stream you would get for the same channel that you pay for. You see, cable companies have to fit so many channels down a single coaxial line that they rely on heavy compression for the video streams. So the video will obviously still look good, but you'll definitely notice compression artifacts if you look carefully. However, over-the-air TV signals don't have this problem. They're still compressed a little bit, but nowhere close to the same degree as cable channels. So these channels, particularly the HD ones, will look really good, even better than cable. Besides the setup though, receiving your TV through an antenna isn't much different from cable. If your TV has a built-in guide feature, you'll still be able to use that to browse through all the channels and see what's on. It will have what's coming up next and what's on right now. And if you want, you can also set up a DVR the same way you would with a cable box. You can see here on my guide, there are quite a few channels to look through. Most of it's just junk, but the main lower channels all have stuff that you're used to, the news, primetime television, and the local channels probably won't have anything good running during the day, but at least you'll get the news at night and those main shows. I should also point out that it's definitely possible to have both cable and antenna depending on your setup. If you have a cable box that uses HDMI or RCA wires to put your video to the TV, you'll still have that coaxial plug on the back of the TV that you can use with an antenna. Or alternatively, you could get a converter box for the antenna, which would output the video through something other than coaxial. Though if your TV is older than about 2007, you probably will have to get a converter box anyway, since that's when TV stations switch from analog to digital, and older TVs might not support that. Now, when you get your TV over the air, there are some quirks that you'll notice. For example, with many of the channels you get, there are also sub-channels, like channel 3-1, 3-2, and the channel might broadcast different signals simultaneously, whether it's a totally different programming, or maybe one is HD and one is SD. Or maybe one of the sub-channels is only for weather or public access, that sort of thing, you get the idea. And many of these sub-channels are not available when you get cable, that you can only get them through over the air. All right, now before I had briefly touched on the fact that you can buy antennas that have different ranges. And depending on how far from the TV towers you are, or what kind of terrain is around you and signal strength, you'll need a certain antenna size. There are really small ones that are around 25 mile range, and there are enormous metal ones that go outside that have ranges of like 100 miles or more. As for the technical aspects of TV antennas, they'll receive one of two types of signals, either VHF or UHF, which stand for very high frequency and ultra high frequency, referring to the radio waves, of course. Now, VHF is for channels 2 to 13, and UHF is for 14 to 83 or above. VHF uses the lower frequency, larger wavelength band between 30 to 300 megahertz, and UHF is from 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. These frequency bands have different properties in terms of different signal ranges and how well they deal with obstructions. For example, because UHF is a higher frequency and therefore a shorter wavelength, it can be received with smaller antennas than VHF. However, VHF, on the other hand, the signals will propagate better across terrain obstructions like valleys and hills. So there's a little bit of advantages for each. In my experience, almost all the channels come in crystal clear, but there are a few channels that are really far away and they are completely unwatchable because the signal is too weak and it just looks like a mess. And my apartment also isn't on the ground floor, so I get a little bit of an elevation that way, which will help with the reception. So if you're on the higher floor, that would help, but if you're on the ground floor or in a valley or something, you'd probably want to mount it up higher if you can. Besides all that though, the main question is why should you care about all this? As for me, I wish I had known more about over-the-air TV before. Considering how little I watch TV, I wouldn't have even gotten a basic cable package from the cable company, because the only reason I got that was to just have the main few network channels anyway. At this point, if I can get those for free with a cheap antenna, it's a no-brainer. This is especially so considering that for the TV shows I do watch, like on HBO, I can typically just get a streaming service to watch them. For example, HBO has HBO Now, which is like $15 a month, as well as like Showtime and other premium channels. No need to go through the cable company, and you aren't locked into a contract. You can just buy the service as long as your show is airing and cancel it after the season finale. It's way better. So we may as well talk about some of the other alternative options for cable besides just broadcasted networks. These days, there are a few devices you can choose from. The big ones are there's Apple TV, Roku, Amazon Fire TV, and Android TV devices like the Nvidia Shield. Although you might not even need any of these if you have a smart TV that includes streaming apps right out of the box. Once you have the device, you'll be able to use it to connect to any number of streaming services. The big one is Netflix, obviously. I think we all know about that one. And the ones I already mentioned are HBO Now and Showtime. And there's also Amazon Prime Video, which has been adding a lot of TV shows recently, both originals and from cable channels. And finally, the other big one is Hulu, which has been around for a while. These services vary in price, but they're typically in the $8 to $15 range. Considering how expensive cable is these days, it's probably possible to get multiple streaming services to cover almost all the cable shows anyway for a fraction of the cable price. And obviously the only difference is you can't watch the show live and you might have to wait a day or so, but that might not be a big deal for you. In any case, the main point of this video is to inform you guys about another way to get TV besides just going through the cable company. Maybe some of you already knew about all this all along, but I'm sure there are those of you younger than me who hadn't even considered getting an antenna. I know I didn't. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think down in the comments section. And if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Should be worth it. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.